Hi children, I hope you all are fine at home with your parents. Today we are going to discuss the chapter 4, The Great Indian Desert. Children, we know in chapter 1 we discussed some of the landforms in our India, that means physiographic divisions. In physiographic divisions, we know there are 6 types are there. There are the Northern Plains, the Northern Mountains, the Great Indian Desert, the Coastal Plains, the Southern Plateau, and the Islands. From Chapter 2 and Chapter 3, we already discussed the Northern Mountains and the Northern Plains. From this chapter, we discussed about the Great Indian Desert. Children, when you hear the word desert, what is the first thing in your mind? Yes, sand. So, whenever you hear the word desert, we have to feel the first name is a sand. The another one is a hot and dry. But do you know, when people think of desert, then usually think of sand. But they have the tiny particles of rocks and minerals that also occur on beaches. In fact, only about 20% of the world's desert are covered in sand. Children, please listen. Only about 20% of the world's desert are covered in sand. Most deserts are mainly made up rocks or gravel, while others are icy. So please, not only sand, they have more other things also, like rocks or gravel, while others are icy. We know very well, the deserts are the driest place on earth. Children, we know, the deserts are 4 main types. These are hot deserts, cold deserts, coastal deserts, and semi-arid desert. So children, these 4 main types, yes, they all have things in common, including very little rainfall, few animals and plants, and strong winds. But the last one, semi-arid desert, it is a bit cooler than hot and dry desert. So children, what are the 4 main types of deserts? Yes, hot deserts, cold deserts, coastal deserts, and semi-arid deserts. So children, these are the 4 main types of deserts. Okay children, now we are going to discuss about Indian desert. Because in our India, we know there are 14 deserts are there. Yes, so in 14, which is the largest desert in India? Of course, the Thar desert. What is it? The Thar desert. So which is the largest desert in India? Yes, the Thar desert is the largest desert in India. So today we are going to discuss about the Thar desert. The Thar desert, it can also call the Great Indian Desert. What is the another name of the Thar desert? Yes, the Great Indian Desert. So children, where is the Thar desert located? We know very well, to the west of Northern Plains lies the Great Indian Desert or the Thar desert. So it is located in the northwestern part of India, in the state of Rajasthan. So it covers the major part of Rajasthan. So it is located in a northern western part of India. Okay children, so it mostly covers the Rajasthan. Yes, a part of it lies in the Punjab and Sindh province of eastern Pakistan. So children, to the west lies the Indus River plain. To the southeast is the Aravalli Range. The Ranaf Kutch lies to the south and the Punjab plain is located in the north and northeastern part of the desert. So children, the Thar desert is bordered by the Satluj river basin on the northeast, and it has a salt marsh known as the Rann of Kutch towards its south, and the southeast lies to the range of Aravalli hills. The desert extends west into Pakistan till the Indus river basin. So children, the Satluj river basin on the northeast and Rann of Kutch in the south, the Aravalli hills range lies southeast, and the desert extends west into Pakistan till the Indus river basin. So children, the Rajasthan is mostly covered the desert part. Children, do you know which is the largest desert in the world? Which is the largest desert in the world? Yes, Antarctic desert. So Antarctic desert is the largest desert in the world. And which is the largest hot desert in the world? Which is the largest hot desert in the world? Yes, Sahara. Sahara is the largest hot desert in the world. Do you know, children? The average temperature 30 degrees Celsius. At the same time, hottest temperature is 58 degrees Celsius in Sahara. So here, the average annual temperature is 30 degrees Celsius and the hottest temperature is 58 degrees Celsius. And one more thing, do you know the only one continent which does not have a desert? Yes, here in every continent they have a desert in a different types, but in a only one continent we cannot find a desert, that is Europe. Yes, Europe is the only continent which does not have a desert. So children, the Europe is the only continent which does not have a desert. So which is the largest desert in India? Which is the largest desert in the India? Yes, the Thar desert. Now we know the largest desert in India is the Thar desert. So what about the length and the breadth of the Thar desert? Yes children, it is about 800 kilometers long and 500 kilometers wide. That means northeast to southwest is 800 kilometers and east to west is 500 kilometers wide. That means length is 800 kilometers and breadth is 500 kilometers. That's only the largest desert in India is the Thar desert. Do you know the Great Indian Desert is the 17th largest desert in the world? The Great Indian Desert is the 17th largest desert in the world. It covers over 2 lakh square kilometer area spread in both India and Pakistan. So children, which is the 17th largest desert in the world? Yes, the Thar desert or the Great Indian Desert. So children, we know what is a desert. It is a flat area covered with thick sheet of loose sand. Plants cannot grow in this region due to dry and lack of water. So what is a desert? It is a flat area covered with thick sheet of loose sand. So desert is a flat area covered with thick sheet of loose sand. Here plants cannot grow in this region due to dry land and lack of water. Children, in this video we will discuss about location, landform, climate and vegetation. So from this video, we have to see location, climate, landform, and vegetation. We know very well. Desert means it is a hot and dry. So, our India, that means the Thar desert, is hot and dry, and it's severely short of water. It has extremes of hot and cold weather during summer, when the days are very hot, at night bitterly cold. So children, the days are pleasant, however the nights are bitterly cold. That means in a daytime we can feel very hot, at the night we can feel very cold. Yes, because the reason for this quick change of temperature is that during the day sand heats up very fast, and during the night sand cools down very quickly. So sand heats up quickly and cools faster than water, because sand is darker than water. What is it? Sand is darker than water. Dark color materials will absorb more light. We know very well the dark color materials will absorb more light. That's only our sand is quickly hot and cool faster than water. Yes, frequently dust storms on long summer days keep people indoors. We know very well what you mean by the word storm. That means dust storm. Children, the dust storm we can call sandstorms also. The dust storm is also we can call a sandstorms. Moreover, hot and dry winds that blow at very high speed carry clouds of sand with them. These are called sandstorms. That means hot and dry winds that blow at very high speed carry clouds of sand with them. Thus, we can call a sandstorms. At the same time, the sandstorm is also known as a dust storm. That means a strong wind carrying clouds of sand with it, especially in a desert. So in a desert area, we can see the sandstorms. So it is common in a Thar desert. Here, the dust storms are common in the month of May and June. This region hardly receives any rainfall. So May and June are the hottest months, with temperatures soaring up to 45 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius. During winters, the temperature varies from 4 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius. So children, the January is the coldest month of the season. So here, the dust storms is very common in months of May and June. And children, in the time, that means the summer days, the people keep in indoors because of the dust storms. Frequently, dust storms on long summer days keep people in indoors, as opposed to summer days in winter are pleasant in the Thar, and nights are extremely cold, as there is no moisture in the dry winds of the Thar desert. So children, during summer the days are long and the temperature is scorching hot. What do you mean by the word scorching? It means extreme heat. What is it? Extreme heat. So in a temperature in a summer days, it is a extreme heat. That means a scorching hot. That means hot and dry winds blow during the day. The nights are however cooler. So in winter, the days are pleasant, however the nights are bitterly cold. Rainfall is very scanty in the desert. So normally it does not rain in the Thar. Here What do you mean by the word scanty? It means very less. What is it? Very less. So, the tar has no permanent reverb. The only reverb here is loony. Heads filled with water during the rainy season. The rainwater also seeps under the ground and fills up some streams. So, which is the only one river in a thar desert? Yes, loony. Loony is the one of the river in a thar desert.
Hey children, let's discuss about the landform. Here, the desert has an undulating surface. We know very well, the surface means is know very well, the floor. Yes, what do you mean by the word undulating surface? It means nothing but having a smoothly rising and falling form, like a wave. Yes, so undulating surface means is moving to up and down. Yes, like a wave, the surface is smoothly rising and falling form. That is, we can call a undulating surface. So, the desert has an undulating surface with high and low sand dunes. What do you mean by the word sand dunes? Sand dunes means is nothing but is a small hills. Sand dunes means small hills. That means sand formed due to the deposit of the large amount of sand carried by wind. Yes, we know very well, the sand is a lightweight. When the wind is flowing very fast, yes, at the time the sand is moving from place to place and stored in another place. So that time the sand dunes, that means manal made. Yes, it will change the place also. So sand dunes means it formed due to the deposit of large amount of sand carried by wind. In Tamil we can say manal made. Yes, small hills. So we can see the desert has an undulating surface with a high and low sand dunes. The winds in the desert region move the sand dunes from one place to another. We know very well, the sand dunes is always changing the direction and the places also because of the wind. Yes, so these dunes are in continuous motion and take an varying shapes and size. So the sand dunes may rise to a height of 500 feet. So we know very well, sand dunes means is nothing but it is a small hill. In Tamil we can say manal medu. Yes, so in our desert we cannot find the same sand dunes in the same direction. Yes, if you are seeing one of the 11 o'clock, that means the morning we can see the one of the different shape of the sand dunes, and the afternoon and the evening it will changing the shape and sizes according to the wind. Yes children, the next, there are many different kinds of soil found in the thar desert, such as the desert soil, brown gray soil, red and yellow soils, and soft loose soil called rugosal. Yes, so in a desert area also we can see the different types of soil. These soils are not fertile. Fertile means we know very well it's good for the growth. Yes, the good for the growth, but the desert soils is not fertile. That means it's not for plants growth. Yes, it's not good for the plants growth. And because of severe wind erosion, they are blown away with the sand. So the plants is hold the soil tightly. So here we cannot having any one soil erosion, because in a desert we cannot find mostly the plants. So when the wind is flow, what happened? The sand also flowing with the wind. So the having we can see the soil erosion. In thar desert, there is scarcity of water in the thar desert. So children, what is scarcity? That means in short supply. Yes, so here the water is a short supply. Yes, so water from the seasonal rainfall is collected in tanks and reservoirs and is used for drinking and domestic purposes. People are now reverting to storing water by using traditional methods of water storage. The groundwater is brackish and saline and is unfit for drinking. So children, at some places in the desert, the underground water comes to the surface. Such a place in the desert, which has water and thus vegetation, is referred to as an oasis. So children, in a dark place also, we have to find some water. Yes, so the underground water comes to the surface. Such a place in the desert, we can call a oasis. So what is definition of oasis? A fertile spot in a desert where water is found. Otherwise, an oasis is a pool of water in a desert. So oasis means it is a pool of water in a desert.
Because of the low rainfall, the water is very important for the Thar desert. So we can get from other ways, that means the man-made, otherwise the artificial, yes, man-made or artificial waterway for irrigating land. So we can get water from river Satluj has been brought to the desert through the Rajasthan canal, which is also called the Indira Gandhi canal. So canal means we know very well, it is an artificial waterway for irrigating land. Yes, so the canals are an important source of water supply in the Thar desert. So the Indira Gandhi canals irrigates the large amount of land in the Thar desert. So we know very well, the canal begins at where the Satluj and Bias rivers meet. So where the Satluj and Bias river meets, that point we can start from the Indira Gandhi canal and continues in the southwest direction for 470 kilometers. No children, the Indira Gandhi canal is the largest canal in India. So which is the largest canal in India? Yes, the Indira Gandhi canal. So Indira Gandhi canal is the largest canal in India. So here the hydroelectric power is supplied to a number of towns by the Bakra Nangal power plant. We know very well, the Bakra Nangal dam is built across the Satluj river in Punjab. There are a few roadways and railway lines in this region. Let's talk about vegetation. Children, we know our neighbors, that means our surrounding place, we can see the different types of trees and plants. So what kind of trees and plants we can find in desert area? Yes, due to scanty rainfall in the desert region. What do you mean by the word scanty rainfall? It means very less or low rainfall. So scanty rainfall means very less or low rainfall. So due to the low rainfall in the desert region, the vegetation mostly consists of herbs or small plants. Some hardy trees which can bear the drought conditions can be seen at a few places. So because of the climate, here we can find the few types of plants, that means the hardy trees like a cactus. Yes, like that we can see in a desert area. Here the gezri trees grows in the desert region. Here the dust storms are common in the month of May and June. This region hardly receives any rainfall. So May and June are the hottest months, with temperatures soaring up to 45 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius. During winters, the temperature varies from 4 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius. So children, the January is the coldest month of the season. So here the dust storms is very common in months of May and June. Children, let's recall the few things from this topic. Yes, so what is desert? Yes, it is a flat area with loose sand. So it is a flat area with a loose sand. So how many deserts in India? So children, how many deserts are there in India? Yes, 14 deserts. So in India, 14 deserts are there. So which is the largest desert in India? Which is the largest desert in India? Yes, the Thar Desert. The Thar Desert is the largest desert in India. What is the another name of Thar Desert? Yes, the Great Indian Desert. What is it? The Great Indian Desert. Children, so which continent is? Children, is there a desert in every continent? No. Is there a desert in every continent? No. So, which continent has no desert? Which continent has no desert? Is Europe. Europe is a continent. It have a no desert. So, only one continent is does not have a desert. That is Europe. Okay, children. In a desert area, we can find a canal. What is the name of the canal? Yes, the Indira Gandhi Canal. What is it? Indira Gandhi Canal. Do you know which is the largest canal in the India? Which is the largest canal in India? Yes, the Indira Gandhi Canal. What is it? The Indira Gandhi Canal. Children, the Indira Gandhi Canal have any other name? That means, what is the another name of Indira Gandhi Canal? Yes, the Rajasthan Canal. What is it? Rajasthan Canal. So children, which is the starting point of Indira Gandhi Canal? Yes, where rivers Satluj and Bias meet. What do you mean by the word sand dunes? Sand dunes means is nothing but small hills. That means Manal Meadows. Sand dunes means small hills. Okay, what is the meaning of undulating surface? It means nothing but having a smoothly rising and falling form. That means like a wave. Okay children, what do you mean by the word scanty rainfall? It means very less or low rainfall. Okay children, let's discuss book exercise. Take your page number 36. A. State whether the following statements are true or false. Question number 1. The Great Indian Desert lies towards the east of the northern plains. The Great Indian Desert lies towards the east of the northern plains. The answer is false. The answer is false. Second one. In the desert, only the plants of the cactus family grow. In the desert, only the plants of the cactus family grow. The answer is false. The answer is false. Third one. A place in the desert which has water and hence vegetation is called an oasis. A place in the desert which has water and hence vegetation is called an oasis. The answer is true. The answer is true. Fourth one. Deserts can be hot as well as cold. Desert can be hot as well as cold. The answer is true. The answer is true. Fifth one. The Luni is the only river that drains into the Thar Desert. The Luni is the only river that drains into the Thar Desert. The answer is true. The answer is children, take your page number 37. Name the following. Question number 1. The capital of Rajasthan. The capital of Rajasthan. The answer is Jaipur. The answer is Jaipur. Second one. Hot and dry winds blowing at very high speed, carrying clouds of sand. Hot and dry winds blowing at very high speed, carrying clouds of sand. The answer is sandstorms. The answer is sandstorms. Third one. People of the Thar Desert who keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water. People of the Thar Desert who keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water. The answer is Banjaras. The answer is Banjaras. Fourth one. The Buskar Fair is held in this state. The Buskar Fair is held in this state. The answer is Rajasthan. The answer is Rajasthan. Fifth one. It is a rain-fed river in the Thar Desert. It is a rain-fed river in the Thar Desert. The answer is Luni. The answer is Luni.